When a female tiger spots a man in the forest, she brings her dying cub to him and begins to cry, begging for help. And, despite his fear, he does something truly unbelievable. The emerald heart of the Sundarbans thrummed with its usual symphony of life. Insects buzzed, monkeys chattered, and somewhere deep in the mangrove thickets, a hidden predator stalked its prey. For AJ, these sounds formed the comforting backdrop to his daily patrols. He knew this forest like his own backyard. Yet, today, something was off. The usual alertness of the wildlife felt muted. Their call seemed less frequent. An instinctive wariness prickled the back of his neck. It was in the curve of a startled deer's back and the sudden silence of a flock of birds. Something was amiss. Then he saw her. The Bengal tigress emerged from the jade gloom like an apparition. She was the undeniable, unassailable queen of the jungle. But her eyes, those burning pools of amber that typically held the wild spirit of the jungle, now swam with an alien vulnerability. Tigers weren't known for docility. A low growl was the best outcome you could hope for during an unexpected encounter. But this tigress neither snarled nor fled. Instead, she sank to the ground. There was no aggression. Instead, every ounce of her powerful form radiated desperation. That's when AJ saw it. A cub was concealed in the dappled shade. At that moment, his heart twisted in a knot of dread and compassion. The tigress didn't need to roar or snarl to communicate her intent. With a gentle nudge of her massive head, she turned and melted back into the undergrowth. She stood in the shadows, but her gaze remained fixed on AJ. This wasn't a challenge or a trap. It was a plea, raw and unmistakable, a mother's plea. AJ's ranger training warred with a swell of unexpected protectiveness. The cub should have been a bundle of playful energy, but he lay limp as a discarded rag. The baby tiger's fur was matted and dull. Shallow breaths rattled in his too small chest, and his eyes were glazed and unfocused. This wasn't a playful injury or even an accidental wound. This went deeper, and it wouldn't be an easy fix. Despite the fear gnawing at him, AJ knelt beside the cub. The tigress watched, her body tensed. This was more than simply allowing an outsider into her sanctuary. It was an act born of the deepest despair, possibly the last glimmer of hope in a mother's heart. AJ reached out hesitantly. This level of trust from an apex predator bordered on the unbelievable. When his hand grazed the cub's side, the tigress stiffened. Another growl, guttural and instinctive, rose in her throat, but it died before reaching her muzzle. AJ's hand stilled. Never, in his years of experience, had he witnessed such vulnerability from a tiger. This fearless guardian of the forest was not only allowing a stranger near her helpless cub, she was begging for assistance, for a miracle she couldn't provide herself. Every cell in AJ's body screamed at him to back off. Years of training and ingrained warnings from countless mentor figures demanded that he retreat to a safe distance. Tigers were unpredictable, and they were territorial. Even when injured or vulnerable, they could inflict lethal damage with a single swipe of a paw. This was madness, pure and simple. The cub let out a weak mewling cry. Protocol be damned, AJ thought. How could he walk away knowing he'd done nothing? At the very least, he could assess the situation and radio for backup if things turned dangerous. One thing his seasoned eyes couldn't miss was the cub's fading energy. Every ragged breath and every flicker of dull eyes was a countdown to a tragic end. Doing nothing felt a whole lot crueler than the risk of a tiger's wrath. AJ's fingers fumbled with the radio. He sent out a terse message, injured cub, tigress present, requesting backup and veterinary assistance. He knew help would be slow in reaching this secluded corner of the forest. He was on his own for now. Keeping his movements slow and deliberate, AJ knelt closer to the cub. His hands hovered over the cub while he assessed the situation. The first step was visual, what he could see. He noted the labored breathing and the sickly pallor of the cub's gums. Each tiny detail filled in a grim picture. Gently, AJ eased the cub onto its side. It whimpered a weak protest against the intrusion. There it was, half concealed by leaves and matted fur, a cruel wire snare bit deep into the cub's flesh. The wound was angry and inflamed, and the sickly sweet smell of infection permeated the humid air. This wasn't an accident. This was deliberate cruelty. The dark reality of poachers constantly cast a shadow over AJ's work. He hated them, and this was why. A surge of anger coursed through him, hot and bitter. He'd seen this too many times. The victim of man's greed, left to suffer agonizing deaths. The tigress flinched when he gently probed the wound. AJ wished he could explain. He wanted to reassure her that this pain was necessary, a vital step towards healing. But all he could do was keep his voice soft and his movement steady. If this delicate trust shattered now, the cub, and perhaps even he himself, would pay the price. He cut away at the matted fur to reveal the full extent of the damage. The cub mewled, and the tigress tensed. Every muscle in her powerful body rippled with an instinctual urge to protect. A deep growl, one AJ recognized as a precursor to an attack, echoed through the small clearing. He froze. One wrong move, one flinch of fear, and this fragile truce would shatter. The backup he'd summoned felt impossibly distant. All he had was the connection he'd forged with this extraordinary creature, a connection born of shared desperation and a mother's love. The tigress leaned forward. He could feel her breath hot against his exposed skin. An eternity stretched between his heartbeats. Then, she did the unthinkable. With a soft, almost pleading whine, she nudged the cub closer to him. She sounded like she was crying, as if begging him for help. It was a gesture so counter to every tiger instinct, so laden with vulnerability, that tears threatened to blur AJ's vision. She understood, not in some complex, rational manner, but in the primal language of motherhood. Her child was suffering. AJ was his last hope. This wasn't compliance or resignation. This was a mother placing the life of her cub in the hands of a man. It was a gamble made in the absence of any other option. AJ's throat tightened with emotion. He wouldn't fail her. However, time was a cruel enemy. He knew the cub was slipping away. Each rasping breath was a dwindling flicker of life. He didn't have the luxury of sterile equipment or proper medication. He did, however, have field training, a basic first aid kit, and the unwavering trust of an apex predator watching his every move. With swift, careful movements, AJ cut at the snare and freed the cub's wounded leg. Next came cleaning the angry wound. The antiseptic stung as it flushed out the infection. The tigress shifted uneasily. It wasn't enough, not nearly enough. The infection was too deep. Without antibiotics, the cub would almost certainly succumb. His best chance was the vet team who should, with any luck, be making their way through the dense forest now. Just when AJ feared the fragile flame of the cub's life was about to gutter and die, the telltale crackle of undergrowth and muffled voices echoed through the clearing. Relief surged through him, but at the same time, a new tension took root. Backup was here, help was here, but how would the tigress react? Mohan, another ranger, let out a low whistle at the sight of the tigress. The wildlife veterinarian, Dr. Priya, took one look at the scene and moved with quiet efficiency. The tigress sensed the change in energy. She bristled, and her low growl sent shivers down AJ's spine. Years of ingrained instinct weren't so easily overridden, even by extraordinary circumstances. "Easy, girl, easy," AJ murmured. His voice was low and soothing. It was vital that the tigress didn't interpret the new arrivals as a threat. Her trust, however fragile, was their only safety net. Priya crouched low. The tools of her trade were momentarily tucked away. The tensest standoff AJ had ever experienced was about to unfold. The tigress flew up and paced a tight circle. Her eyes were ablaze. Mohan and Priya exchanged tense glances. Understanding dawned in their eyes. "What do we do?" Priya whispered. AJ knew what not to do. Sudden movements, loud voices, any of that could trigger an attack. "Give me space," he instructed. "She trusts me, and for now, that trust extends to my intentions, but we can't push it." He turned towards the tigress. Slowly, as if demonstrating complete lack of threat, he lowered himself to the ground. AJ spoke, not to the others, not even to himself, but to the tigress. His words were a soothing murmur, a litany of reassurances and promises. He told her about the medicine, about the help it would bring. Even if she didn't understand the specifics, he hoped his tone would convey his intentions. Priya pressed a syringe into his hand. One fluid movement brought him within inches of the cub. He felt the heat radiating from the tigress and heard her shallow, anxious breaths. Inches away, amber eyes filled with both fear and desperate hope tracked his every move. With slow, deliberate precision, he administered the antibiotic shot. The cub flinched and let out a pathetic cry. AJ froze. His heart pounded in his ears. Then, slowly, like a storm cloud receding, the tension seemed to drain from the tigress. She let out a long, shuddering breath and settled beside her cub. It wasn't acceptance of defeat. It was the thinnest thread of hope. Hours blurred into an endless stretch of tension and whispered updates. Dr. Priya worked tirelessly. The cub was buoyed by the antibiotics, but drifted in and out of consciousness. The baby tiger's breaths were less labored, and a touch of color had returned to its muzzle. It was too early to declare victory, but a delicate balance had replaced the immediate threat of death. "We need to move him," Priya said. "There's only so much I can do here." Slowly, with both eyes fixed on the tigress, he wrapped the cub in his jacket. He handed the cub to Priya, and she retreated with Mohan. AJ was alone with the tigress once more. She gazed intently at the spot where her cub had vanished. Then, with one last look at him, she melted into the forest, vanishing as silently as she had appeared. AJ stood there for a long time. The fading evening light filtered through the canopy. This encounter had broken boundaries and rewritten the age-old rules between man and beast. Weeks stretched into a month as the cub recovered. He was eventually released back into the forest, and the rangers believed that they would never see him again, at least not this close. But the memory of the tigress remained a constant hum in the back of AJ's mind. His patrols took him through that secluded section of forest more often than strictly necessary, and his eyes always scanned for a flash of stripes, some kind of sign that she was thriving. Then, one morning, just as the first rays of sunlight pierced the thick canopy, his heart skipped a beat. There she was, unmistakable in her regal bearing. But something was different. A movement in the shadows behind her made him gasp. Two cubs, healthy and vibrant, tumbled playfully at her heels. AJ swallowed hard as one of the cubs moved with a slight, distinctive limp. His act of compassion, his choice to defy training and follow his heart, had caused ripples he never could have imagined. He wasn't just a ranger that day. He was a lifeline, a force for good in a world too often filled with cruelty. And now, the legacy of that day lived on. And it was written in the playful dance of those cubs and the protective watch of their extraordinary mother. What a beautiful ending. Do you have a story about a wildlife rescue? Tell us about it in the comments. We'd love to hear. For now, though, we're done. Catch you in the next video.